My hand's kind of purple from blood.
Hallie Duncan doesn't remember anything about her first week at Baptist.
They said that they were trying to mess with me or do something, and I was just going crazy, kicking in the bed. But I was just tired of them messing with me.
The 18-year-old, though, is thankful she can joke about it now and is headed home.
I'm good today. I'm ready to go, so I can go sleep in my own bed.
Nearly 2 weeks ago, Hallie was rushed to Baptist after she suffered a pulmonary embolism, likely caused by birth control pills, that blocked off most of the blood flow to her lungs. She went into cardiac arrest several times on the way to the hospital. Her surgeon says if it hadn't been for this machine, she wouldn't have survived.
She had had some bleeding earlier in the day from various CPR and some chest tubes that she had, and we couldn't give the clot-busting medicine. And also, we couldn't do surgery on her because she was too ill.
That's the scar that they had where they had the tube through my leg.
Instead, Hallie was hooked up to the ECMO machine that oxygenates the patient's blood outside the body and essentially takes over for the heart and lungs.
So we put one tube in her case, we put one tube in the femoral artery and one tube in the femoral vein. And then the unoxygenated blood comes out of the vein and it goes through this machine, oxygenates it, and then pumps it back into the body.
Doctors say because Hallie is so young, she recovered right away and was off the machine in a couple of days. Hallie will have to take some time away from college and is now on blood thinners, but says she's starting to feel like her old self again.
I think it's one of the better stories we've had, just knowing that she's going to have just a completely normal life now when she no doubt would have died for sure if we hadn't have done this.
I don't guess I was ready to go.
In East Memphis, Melissa Moon, WREG News Channel 3.